Problem 11. The substitution method should be used to solve which system of equations? So, solving system linear equation, we have three methods. We have graphing, substitution, and elimination. We use graphing for all cases. Substitution, when you have, it's more convenient when you have either x or y by itself. And elimination, when you have x and y on the same side. So, in this case, we talk about substitution method, which means that we look for an equation that has x, either x or y by itself. So A, this is x and y on the same side, is good for elimination, not for substitution. This also have x and y on the same side, that's for elimination. This one you have y by itself, and the last one you have x and y by itself. So the best option here is problem C, when y already by itself. Alright, problem 12. Use elimination method to solve the system x minus y equal to 2, x plus 4y equal to negative 8, and solve for y. Okay, so we have x minus 6y. X minus 6y equal to 2, x plus 4y equal to negative 8. So we're gonna use elimination method, mean that you're gonna add two equations and something will be cancel each other out. As we see that we want to keep y because they ask you solve for y, so we want to cross out the x. We have to do is change the sign of one of the equations. So I'm gonna say that I picked the first one. So I multiply the first equation by negative 1, which change all the sign. Then we will add two equations. X will cancel each other out, and 6y plus 4y is 10y equal to negative 2 plus negative 8 is negative 10. Then we divide both sides by 10, you will have y equal to negative 1. And pretty much it, you don't have to plug it in because they ask you solve for y, so y is negative 1. That's all. Now we go to number 13, solve the system of equation for y. So they want you to solve for y, which means that I want to cancel out the x. Okay, and since x and y on the same side already, I'm going to use elimination method. So I need the same number in front of x. So first equation, I will multiply by 5 and distribute it in. That will give you 30x. Plus 10y equal to 10. And to get 30x on the second equation, I have to multiply it by 6 and distribute it in. That will be 30x plus 12y equal to 0, because 6 times 0 is 0. Now to cancel out the x, you need the opposite sign of the x. So I'm gonna do is change the sign of the second equation, or technicality is you multiply with negative 1 to change all the sign. So it's turned into negative, and 0 don't have negative, so you don't have to put negative 0. 30x and 30x cancel each other out. 10y minus 12y is negative 2y equal to 10 minus 0 is 10. Then we divide both sides by negative 2. So y equal to negative 5 is the final answer for number 13. Now number 14. Define variables and write a system of equation to model the following problem. Then solve the system to answer the equations. ASB set a table for a banquet at school. Each round table can seat 5 people, and each square table can seat 8 people. They had to set up a table for 98 people. We need 4 more round table than a square table. How many of each type of table will they need? Alright, so first of all, I'm sorry that I didn't give you space to do number 14. So go ahead, do number 14 on a separate sheet of paper and staple it with your packet. Alright, so we need to know two things. First of all, they're talking about a round table and a square table. We don't know how many table that we need for the banquet, but we know that round table, you can fit 5 people in that table, and square table, you can fit 8 people in that table, and the guest that we're gonna have is 98 people. Okay, and they did give you additional information. They need 4 round table than a square table. Alright, so first of all, we need to define the variable. So let's say if I say x is the amount of, let's say, round table first. Round table. Okay, then that leads to y is the amount of square table. Square table. Alright, so we know that 5 people for each round table plus 8 people for each square table, and the total of guests we need to fit in the table is 98 people. So 5x plus 8y equal to 98. They need 4 more round table than square table. Okay, so round table is x. They need 4 more than square, which means square plus 4. Square table, 4 square, the amounts of square table plus 4. And that's it. That is the system of linear equation, and we can solve it by elimination method. So, seeing the second equation has x by itself, the best choice is substitution, not elimination. The best choice is substitution. We're going to plug this in the first equation. So that will give you 5 x turned into y plus 4 plus 8y equal to 98. Okay. Then now next step we're going to do is distribute 5 into parentheses. So that will give you 5y plus 20 plus 8y equal to 98. Then we will do is combining like term. You have 5y and 8y will give you 13y plus 20 equal to 98. Then we subtract 20 on both sides to get y by itself. 13y equal to 78. Then we divide both sides by 13. So y equal to 6. Y equal to 6. So again, y is represent for square table. To solve for round table, we have the second equation. When x equal to y plus 4, which means 6 plus 4. So x is 10. So the amount of round table we need is 10 tables. So we need 10 round tables. And that's it. What did they ask you? How many of each type of table we need? So there you go. 6 square and 10 round table. That's all.